I am a serious radio amateur and made many radio, shortwave radios. You can find them on my YouTube channel. Written books about how to make shortwave radios, also demonstrated in the past this FM radio receiver that worked. But I made a circuit a few years ago that still gives a lot of questions. And I want to show that circuit again. This is the circuit in real, and it proves that this circuit oscillates without a tank circuit. Normally in a radio we always have a tank circuit, a coil with a capacitor parallel to it, for instance here. That depends how the coil is made, the windings, the number of windings and the parallel capacitor or series capacitor depends on the frequency that you want to generate with such an oscillator. But this circuit works without any visible coil. And here it is. And it's tiny. Of course, when you know something about radio technology, you can have a lot of objections against this circuit. You can, for instance, say, well, here, the wiring here, that plays a role. That wiring, we can consider that as a tank circuit. And there's always parallel capacitance or stray capacitance in the circuit. And that makes that it oscillates on 75 megacycles. Well, we have, in that case, directly to do with the radio theory. And that tells us, these are the basic formulas, a lot about the wavelengths and the possibility that with a certain piece of wire, in whatever way, there is a relation between the length of the wire and the frequency. And these are the basic formulas, and that means that on 75 megahertz we are working in the 4 meter band, full wave. And that means that somewhere when this when there is a hidden antenna somewhere, that has to have a substantial length, 4 meters or so. And you can see directly that this is a very tiny circuit, and I've made it by purpose this way so that I can stick it up directly on the battery also to prevent all kinds of stray inductance effects. So that was one argument against this circuit. Another argument could be, well, when you connect here your scope to watch the signal, that scope, the cable to the scope, this cable can be an antenna of a certain wavelength, or the cable to the counter, that's coax cable, and when you say make certain connections with such a cable, you can use such a cable as a tuned circuit, as a tank circuit. But that's the reason why I want to demonstrate this circuit with this pickup coil. I want to move directly to move the coil to that oscillator in function, and then we can see without any direct connection in terms of a cable to the scope whether it oscillates or not. So that are two main objections, and I've tried to say pay attention to that and say null out all these disturbing factors by making this as tiny as possible by sticking it up directly into that battery. So I want to connect now the oscillator to the battery, and now the thing oscillates. How can I show that it oscillates? Well, when we move the pickup coil in the direction of the oscillator, it must be possible to see on the scope the waveform. I do that now. And here you surely see that sine wave. This is what I'm doing now. I move it closely to the whole setup there. And here we have that sine wave. Well, I now connect it to the counter. Takes some time, of course, always. You've seen that it oscillates without any, say, hidden stray capacitance, hidden coils. It's now connected to the counter. Here's the cable. We follow the cable. And we read 72 megahertz. So, I think this was a good demonstration that it oscillates without a coil. Here the circuit again, made as small as possible, oscillating on that VHF frequency in the 4 meter band. And I don't know why it works, this oscillator. Of course, I know that capacitors can have a certain resonance frequency. Perhaps that's the case in this circuit, could be. But I'm interested, and perhaps people that are better acquainted with the radio technology, perhaps scientists, can give an explanation why this circuit works on 75 megahertz approximately without any indication of a, say, a source on which it can resonate. Perhaps, like I told, the capacitors could be. But even then, I'm interested how that could work. You can set the bias, the working point, with the 10K potentiometer. Furthermore, there's nothing more to tell. I did this experiment a few years ago and also made other videos about it. Anyway, I have a lot of new viewers. So perhaps this is again interesting to pay attention to this kind of magical circuit. Of course, it's no magic, it's science.